Students, we will show you the results of previous experiment also, what we have done. You can you tell me what is this? Are you able to see?
What is this? Antibiotic
sensitivity. Yes.
Antibiotic sensitivity.
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 Yes, now it's clear. Okay.
Yeah.
What is the organism? What is the label written?
E. coli, ma'am.
E. coli.
Are you able to see the zone of inhibition? Is there any
yes,
difference? Is there
yes,
any difference? You have labeled here as T, tetracycline. This is chloramphenicol. This is oxacillin and this is control. You are getting the difference?
Yes,
you see the zone of inhibition, how much different each one is. So this is diameter. Okay, so using a scale, you have to measure the diameter of the zone of inhibition. So this is, remember, this is E. coli cell, and you can see the zone of inhibition for all the three antibiotics, and for the control where we have kept just the disc, you are not able to find any zone of inhibition. Now I'll show you another one sample. See, this is another one. What is this? You are able to see the labeling?
Yes, ma'am.
Staphylococcus.
What are you able to find here? Do you find any zone of inhibition in this sample?
No. No, ma'am.
What is your conclusion? What is the conclusion of this experiment?
Clear.
The organism is resistant. Here,
resistant from staphylococcus.
Yes. They here, the E. coli organism was sensitive, and all the zones I have measured, it is starting from 15 mm only. So that means the organism is highly sensitive, E. coli. But staphylococcus, there was no any zone of inhibition. So that shows that the organism is resistant to all the antibiotics. Okay, so this is the result for your next this experiment. I will post the pictures for you for your record purposes. Even today, I'll post all the pictures to you.